Ever wonder why we haven't found aliens yet? It's not because they're just a figment of our imagination, it might be because they're zipping around at unimaginable speeds. Even earthly objects can become invisible when they move at breakneck speed. But what about those super-fast, super-advanced civilizations? Professor Robin Hansen suggests that if extraterrestrial life can travel at the speed of light, we won't spot them until they're here on Earth. So, the race is on. Can we catch up to them in time? But hold on, before we start worrying about potential alien invasions, let's dive into the Kardashev scale. Back in 1964, Soviet scientist Nikolai Kardashev devised a scale to measure the development of civilizations based on their energy consumption. The more advanced a society, the more energy it needs. Sounds simple, right? Historically, from 1800 to 2015, Earth's population surged sevenfold, while energy consumption skyrocketed 25-fold. Yet, we're still far from being a Type 1 civilization. To reach this level, we'd need to tap into our planet's maximum energy and harness power from the nearest star. Easy, right? Well, not exactly. Currently, 65% of our energy comes from conventional sources like coal, oil, and gas. But being a Type 1 civilization isn't just about advanced tech, it also requires globalism and universal access to knowledge. American astronomer Carl Sagan added that such a society should have a global economy with free markets and democratic governance. So, if a Type 1 civilization exists nearby, our telescopes equipped with technosignature detectors might catch a glimpse. Now, imagine a Type 2 civilization, no political conflicts, no economic crises. They're masters at harnessing not only their planet's energy but also that of the nearest star. The dream? A Dyson sphere, a hypothetical structure that wraps around a star, capturing its power for the civilization's use. Imagine having the power to vaporize a moon-sized threat. Cool, right? But wait, there's more. A Type 3 civilization can harness the energy of an entire galaxy, possibly utilizing black holes or creating new stars. We're talking about ultimate beings that can rearrange galaxies like construction sets. However, no signs of them yet. Either they don't exist, or they're so advanced that we won't notice until it's too late. Now, some scientists and sci-fi enthusiasts go even further, imagining a Type 4 civilization with control over billions of galaxies. These entities could reshape planetary systems or erase unnecessary cosmic elements. Sounds incredible, right? Well, there's a catch. Ordinary humans might find themselves living in a world dominated by cyborgs, with our descendants as a mere subspecies in this highly evolved society. But don't worry, in this global democracy, we shouldn't have any misunderstandings with our cyborg neighbors. So, as we explore the possibilities of advanced civilizations and their potential encounters with us, the question remains. Are we ready to move up the Kardashev scale and join the cosmic club? Forget about wars, in a Type 5 civilization, humans might not even be considered fit for sports or long space missions. We'd be seen as weaker and more vulnerable. But that's just the beginning. A Type 5 civilization could tap into not just our universe's energy, but also that of all other dimensions if the multiverse theory holds true. Picture extracting infinite energy from countless parallel worlds sounds unreal, doesn't it? Now, let me introduce you to a Type 6 civilization where a supermind can move faster than the speed of light. This entity could command space and time effortlessly, even going back in time to tweak the universe's formation. Intriguing, right? But wait, there's more. Type 7, also known as an Omega civilization, takes it a step further. Members of this society could achieve true immortality by using virtual technology to travel to different pocket dimensions. By curving space-time, they'd create new homes for relocated objects, each with its own set of physics laws. Imagine programming every atom in a pocket dimension. The civilization could keep moving to nested pocket universes indefinitely. Sounds like a headache? Don't worry, we're not diving into these complex technologies anytime soon. The reason we even bother thinking about these advanced civilizations is simple: if humanity doesn't evolve rapidly now, we might never reach Type 1 civilization status. At the moment, we're estimated to be around 0.75 on the Kardashev scale. But hold your celebrations, that doesn't mean we've covered 75% of the way. The scale is logarithmic, so each step requires producing significantly more energy. To put it plainly, to climb just 1/100th of the Kardashev scale, say to 0.76, we'd need to produce 26% more energy than we do now. Why does this matter? Well, aside from self-improvement, NASA has identified about 4,000 exoplanets with potentially life-friendly conditions. If there are advanced civilizations out there, and we're lagging behind, we might miss out on crucial opportunities. Remember Robin Hansen? He argues that claiming Earth's uniqueness in the vast universe is naive. If we don't hurry up the Kardashev scale, we might have nowhere to live soon. Imagine these spheres representing different forms of life. The faster they develop, the fewer chances remain for those not yet type 1. Even in an infinite universe, an Omega civilization could spread endlessly and at infinite speed. So, the question arises, if we encounter them in outer space, would they leave us be or exploit us for energy? Hence, it's not just about avoiding aliens, it's about surpassing them in our development. The race is on. Let's talk about space exploration and what might be holding us back, the Great Filter. Coined by Robin Hansen in 1996, this concept suggests that the faster a form of life evolves, the tougher its journey becomes. While we may not be as advanced as other potential civilizations, our society has matured relatively quickly on a cosmic scale. But here's the catch, instead of space monsters, it's our own actions that might lead to our downfall, like polluting the environment with plastic. According to futurist Michio Kaku, the fate of humankind hangs in the balance within the next 100 years. So, how can we become a Type 1 civilization and avoid becoming cosmic dust? To achieve this seemingly unrealistic goal, we need to take practical steps. Start by installing more solar batteries and wind turbines, simple, right? But that's just the beginning. We must significantly improve existing energy production methods, especially nuclear power. Yes, I know it's a touchy subject, given memories of Chernobyl and Fukushima, but it's a crucial step for overall development. Some progressive countries like Italy, Germany, and Belgium are opting out of nuclear energy, but from a developmental perspective, it's a step backward. More civilization knowledge means fewer unforeseen problems. Without nuclear power plants, we have zero chances of climbing the development scale. Sure, we can explore new alternative energy sources, but even those won't cut it for reaching Type 1 civilization status. Here's the key, remember what I said at the beginning? A Type 1 civilization is characterized by the quality of human rights and global democracy, and that's not exactly our strong suit. We've got super-fast internet, allowing ambitious plans from the comfort of our couches. However, about half the world's population still lacks access to this essential tool. Achieving absolute equality of rights, unlimited freedom, and economic transparency might sound utopian, but it's what we need to strive for. So, the big question is, can we address our problems in time, secure our spot in space, or will we face destruction shortly after launching into the cosmic game? It's a race against time, and our choices today will determine our cosmic fate. Thanks for joining us on this cosmic journey. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and click the video on your screen for more mind-bending content. Until next time, keep gazing at the stars.